I wanted to show you guys how to vectorize a bitmap graphic. The reason I'm showing you this is because it could be really helpful with your logo project. A lot of you guys might choose to do your logo as a sketch first. And if you do sketch your logo in your sketchbook, then you can go ahead and scan it into Photoshop or at basically any other program, save it, bring it into Illustrator, vectorize it, and then basically just start to colorize it directly from the scan. So that's much helpful. That's much more helpful than having to draw it in Illustrator, especially if you're not entirely comfortable with the software yet. So the first thing you're going to do, of course, is in your sketchbook, you'll want to make sure that you have a very clean drawing. What that means is you want to have the black part be as black as it can be and the white part be as white as it can be. So it's best not to have shades of gray. It's really better to do it as pure black, pure white. And the reason that is because it's going to be a challenge for the software, for Illustrator, to vectorize it if there's a lot of different gray tones. So it's really helpful if it's pure white, pure black. And this will work for any template sketch you do. So if you do a lot of really great sketches in your sketchbook and you want to use them as reference or use them to help you draw, it's really great to kind of go over them, make sure you have really pure blacks, and then scan them in, and then you can actually just vectorize them and start working directly with them in Illustrator. So let me show you this. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to place the logo in. I've already scanned it, so it's right here. Notice it's a JPEG image. I'm going to go ahead and click on it, and I'll place it into Illustrator. Notice it looks a little bit pixelated even. That's because it's a little small. The file is a little bit small. That's okay. So I'm going to go ahead and select it. And notice when I select it, what happens? The top right up here, the top bar in Illustrator changes. So when you select any image in Illustrator, you'll get this option to do what's called a live trace. And a live trace will convert that bitmap image, that scanned JPEG, into a Illustrator vector image. Okay, so I'll go ahead and click Live Trace here. After I've clicked Live Trace, it becomes really crisp and clean and clear, and that's because it's all suddenly vectorized. These are all now paths that I'm going to be working with. And I haven't converted it yet. I've just gone to a mode where I can preview it. And I'm in this mode now so that I can really customize and separate the black from the white, so all the pixels that are lighter are converted. And you have this threshold up here. This threshold is really helpful. Mine is really clean. It's pure black and pure white, so it's not having any issues with conversion. But if yours has some gray in it, or you didn't quite color in all that black, you might have a little bit of an issue. You might have to play with this threshold, and it'll just preview it for you. Let me show you. I'm going to go to a really low threshold and see what happens. Oh, it's still converting it for me. So, but what you'll actually end up seeing is you'll see that it's not converted very well, and you'll have to play with this threshold to get the most crisp, clean black. The other thing you can do is go to this preset menu. A really good one to use for black and white drawings is black and white logo. If I click on this, it gives me a threshold of 160 and a minimum area of 4 pixels. This minimum area is the smallest feature in pixels that will be traced. Example, 4 pixels, 2 pixels, 1 pixel. So it's basically what you choose. Once you kind of feel good about what it looks like, you can go ahead and click expand here. Once expand has been clicked, it's no longer a JPEG. Now it is actually an illustration. It's actually a vector image that you can start to work with. But there's only one more thing you might need to do. Because it came in as one element, one photograph, what Illustrator has done is it's basically grouped all of these elements together. And you might want to go ahead and ungroup it. And this will just give you more freedom with colorization. So I'm going to go up to my object menu, and I'm going to choose ungroup here. Once I choose ungroup, nothing's really going to happen. And it's not going to be able to, I'm not going to be able to see anything. But when I deselect it, I'll be able to go up and get my direct selection tool, which is my white arrow. And I can then go in and select certain elements. Like, I'm going to go ahead and select the tongue. Actually, I didn't get the whole tongue, but now I did. I'll zoom in so you can kind of see what I'm doing here. I selected the tongue, and this is the part that I'm going to play with colorizing. So I've opened up one of my Pantone metallic coated color palettes here. Where do you find your Pantone colors? I went over that in class, but let me just show you. I'm going to go back to swatches. If you go into your open swatch libraries here at the bottom of your swatches palette, and you go into color books, which is right up here, you get all these Pantone choices. And remember, you want to start with Pantone because you want to convert that Pantone color to CMYK and then to Web Safe. So I always want to start with a Pantone color box so that I know that I'm choosing a specific color that will go to print. Okay, so I have my Pantone metallic colors open here, and I'm just going to start to look. So maybe I want a blue, or I might want an orange. So I'm just going to kind of see, find a color that works for me. So I'll go for blue, and I'll just select this Pantone 8223C here. Once I select it, notice what happened. My fill is selected, so the whole tongue got filled with blue. If I just wanted to do a stroke, I would select my stroke here, select blue, and then it would be stroked blue. So let's say I want this whole illustration to be stroked this color blue. You would select the whole thing again, so select it all out, and I can just kind of go and drag a box around it actually, and then I can click on this blue here, and it will all turn to a stroke of blue. Or I can choose a different color, a green. Not so much liking that, so I'm going to eliminate the stroke again. And I'm going to go in and I'm going to choose different elements here. So I'll go in and choose, I'm going to deselect and choose the tongue again. And I'm just going to play with this color blue. I'll choose a more gray. And instead of stroke, I'm going to go fill. Choose a fill, choose this gray color again. And then I'll go ahead and select the eye. Oops, it selected the whole thing. You have to make sure you're just selecting the element you want. And I can then, you know, colorize the eye too. Change the eye to be that color. So this is really the colorization process. It's kind of figuring out what color you want. It's playing with color. Once you have your logo in Illustrator, that's the time when you're going to start, and you have it perfectly rendered, of course. That's the time that you're really going to start being playful with color, seeing what colors work with your design. And don't limit yourself. Make sure that you go through lots of different colors, that you really think about your color choices in terms of what content you're trying or message you're trying to convey with your logo. Hopefully this helps. Once you're finished, all you have to do is save your Illustrator file. The actual JPEG is still going to be on your hard drive, but this is a brand new file, so you want to go ahead and save your file, make sure you know where you're saving it, and name it appropriately. I'll name it color, or logo color, underscore color, and I'll go ahead and save it on my desktop here so I know where it is. Save it. Okay. Worked out. And then I can kind of finish experimenting with it.